Why is it that science only makes sense from a Trinitarian perspective?
Well, you got religions like Islam and Judaism, which says there's only one God, one person, one God, that's it. Mm-hmm. The problem of those religions, they can't explain the origin of love. Mm-hmm. Love, by definition, requires at least two personal beings giving love to one another and receiving love mm-hmm. from one another. But then you've got Hinduism, which says there's millions of gods. Mm-hmm. And one of the things we notice about Hindu science, because you've got these millions of gods all participating in creation from different perspectives with different plans, they predict that the realm of nature is going to be filled with chaos, mm-hmm. inconsistencies, incongruities. We don't see that. We look at nature, we see it's governed by a single purpose, a single plan, coming from a single mind. And this is the biblical doctrine of the Trinity, where you got one essence and three persons. Mm-hmm. Three persons in a loving relationship mm-hmm. with one another before they create anything. Mm-hmm. And so in Christianity, God really can be the greatest of all entities, because he's experiencing love before he creates. Mm. He is not compelled to create. Create is a choice. Mm. And yet also explains why the record of nature has such a consistent and harmonious revelation.
Mm. Praise the Lord.
Oh Lord, remind me of your
Hey!